We are in
EPCOT, which stands for the Experimental Prototype Community of Tomorrow.
Gosh, didn't know that.
I'm an EPCOT
nerd.
I should tell you all that I am full of cold, so that is why I have a particularly husky voice at the moment.
We're going to play a fun game and see how long Maddie's voice lasts today.
So Spaceship Earth, it's this geodesical dome, but it's been designed in such a way that when it rains, no water will fall on the floor. The water kind of filters through all of the different, what do you call those?
Well, they're triangles.
Triangles.
Groups of triangles.
I was going to call them scales. They're just triangles. Pyramids?
What do you call them? Three sides. It's a triangle, got it.
Oh dear. EPCOT was actually Walt Disney's baby, and originally he imagined it as a city full of new technologies where people would actually live and come together. However, that didn't quite happen, but it did become a theme park after Walt Disney died.
The park is split into two worlds. There's Future World and World Showcase. Future World has loads of different areas, pavilions.
Yeah,
pavilions. You've got ones all about the planet and the earth and conservation and the seas. And you got one that all about the future and technology. We just need to decide where to start.
That way.
This way.
Yeah.
Oh, that was
Sorry guys, did you get wet too? First ride we are doing is Test Track.
I loved this one we did the first time because you get to like design your own vehicle, which we'll show you the whole thing of.
Oh, then, there it is.
There it is. And then you get to go and ride on, I think it's the fastest roller coaster in Walt Disney World. Can I have one of them for you?
We are going to design the most ridiculous car possible.
Yeah. She is really going silly. Wider, wider. So, do we go efficient with a solar drive or go power and awful with a plasma burner? This is not the real world, so it's okay, Mads.
What colour do we want it to be?
That's ridiculous. Our vehicle has huge power, 71%. Efficiency, 56%. I mean, it's not good, but we're having fun.
Welcome to the Sim Track. We'll begin with the capability test to see how your vehicle designs perform under challenging weather and surface conditions.
Right, here we go. Swap off the camera. So we're not one of today's most powerful vehicles. He was very happy with his
car. He definitely did better than us.
What I love about that ride though is it just gets everyone talking about car design, right? So it's inspiring budding engineers of the future. You're working out what's the most efficient, what's the most powerful, and you get a great ride which puts anyone with long hair all over their face. Let's see an action replay.
We're doing Mission Space. So there are two tracks. You've got green, which is meant to be slightly easier, and then orange. Now, we did the orange track when we were here the other day. So we're gonna do the green one today just to see if it's any different. But the idea is that you are a trainee astronaut.
Oh, it looks so awesome. All right, we're going from Earth on a space mission.
Oh, look.
To Mars.
It's different. Orange is a Mars mission. Orange is a Mars mission, and it looks like green is an Earth mission, so that's the difference.
Should we not just do Mars again?
I want to do the other one, though. Don't
you? Is that because Mars makes you feel sick? Go on, admit it.
The ride is a motion simulator, and it kind of recreates the feeling of G-force. So your arms sort of float around, but it does make you feel super queasy. I want to just do the green one today because I want to see how it's different.
All right then. Both of us are pretty rubbish when it comes to roller coasters, but top tip, if you take
travel sickness tablets,
then actually it stops you getting motion sick on rides.
Yeah, it can really help, but we haven't taken them today, which is why we are going to do the green earth mission.
Yes, we are.
That one.
Guys, is the green one lame?
Aww.
Okay. Are you guys ready?
So ready.
You have been selected to train for a spectacular mission around the Earth.
Going important. In. I'm the navigator.
I'm the pilot.
Oh, you're the pilot, okay.
Okay, get settled. Check out your buttons. Welcome aboard.
Okay. Are you locked and ready to go?
Pilot, the X2 is an excellent ship. Your job will be to trigger first aid separation. Good luck, team. All of us here at Mission Control wish you a safe journey around the planet.
What did you think of the ride?
Capcom, it was very enjoyable. It was great. I really liked it. I like both of them.
So the difference with the Earth mission is that you kind of just go around the Earth and you see, obviously, the countries from space. Actually, I kind of preferred it. I thought it was a little bit more believable, but that one just to make us a little bit sick.
Shh, don't tell them that.
I've never done this before, but I've seen in like other people's Disney vlogs that you can come in here and try different sodas. And apparently there's one from Italy called Beverly, which is meant to be really disgusting. Should we try it?
Yeah, obviously.
Okay, so it's a bitter flavour. It's an aperitif.
Thumbs up.
It's not disgusting. It tastes like tonic. It's got the bitterness of tonic water. You're gonna like that, I think.
That's delicious.
Yeah, I quite like it.
It is very like tonic, but with a slightly herby edge to it.
What are you all talking about? That's nice.
That's great.
Everyone says that's horrible.
It's great.
It's not that bad.
Five.
We have ourselves a date with Crush the turtle from Finding Nemo, so we're going over to the Living Seas Pavilion, which we love because not only is there a Finding Nemo ride, you can chat with Crush, but also it's an aquarium.
Whoa, dude, check out all the humans in the human tank.
Crush was a totally sweet dude, as always, but he mostly talks to the little ones in the room, so we didn't want to film too much, but now we're exploring Sea Base. What have you found?
Fish.
That is a funny looking fish.
Sharks.
Shark.
Shark.
Manatees have been rescued. Looking at their tails, it seems like they've had some kind of run-in with boat propellers. But this is a rehabilitation area, meaning that here they're being looked after and observed before they're released back into the wild.
But manatees are also known as sea cows. They're constant grazers. They eat lots and lots of sea grasses. But here they're eating lettuce heads. And actually, I've been lucky enough to feed them, and their mouths are like big bristly brushes, and they eat them like this. Incredible.
I have an important question for you though.
What's that?
Do you think they're cute or they're ugly?
I think they are ugly cute, and that's a good thing.
Can't really tell. No. So you can actually see there are little animals inside this stony structure that we call coral, and the little animals are called polyps, and you can see them kind of wafting out into the water, and they actually create the stony structure that makes their home that we call coral.
We do Spaceship Earth. We're going to do one of my other favourite rides inside the Land Pavilion. It's called Living with the Land, and it's a little boat ride through some of Epcot's greenhouses, and you learn all about agriculture.
Welcome to our living laboratory, where scientists from Epcot and the U.S. Department of Agriculture are exploring innovative ways to produce bountiful harvests. The common grains growing here, wheat, maize, sorghum, and millet, plus rice, account for nearly two-thirds of our global food consumption. Learning how to increase yields of these staples is an important goal of research around the world. By growing these ground plants vertically, we can increase yields and better control diseases. These crops taste as good as they look.
That one.
So good.
Yeah.
It's all about, you know, talking about how to live with the land, right? To make less of an impact on the land.
Yeah, really good. So interesting. Now we're going to go do Spaceship Earth.
Yes.
It's the end of the day, and both of our batteries are finito, so we're switching back to the phone again. And we are walking under Spaceship Earth. This feels like the best way to end a day here at Epcot. Spaceship Earth is a journey through the past where you learn about the history of communication, as told by Judi Dench.
The Spaceship Earth controls, on behalf of Stevens,
I love it. It's all about the history of science engineering, and then like thinking ahead, like future scoping. Beautiful
ride. It's a classic Epcot ride, but it's still my favourite, definitely. Yeah. But that's it from us here at Epcot. I hope you enjoyed sort of like following us around today.
Yeah, if you did, do subscribe to the channel for much more like this.
Yeah, stay curious, and we'll see you soon.
Yeah, bye.